Hello, my kittens. Long time no see. I'm sorry that I've been so absent. I'll explain that a little later just in case you guys weren't interested in hearing why I've been absent, but I'll start off with something good. So this past weekend I went to IMATS, and I've just got to say on a side note, did anyone else who went find it was a little not as good this year? I don't know. It wasn't as crowded. I guess that was a plus for it because they've changed the age limit and everything, so it wasn't as crowded as normal, but I don't know, it just didn't feel as fun and as good as it normally did. To put it quite simply, I was through and done with it within about an hour and a half to 2 hours, and I was ready to go home. Whereas normally I like to spend the whole day there and just kind of walk around and chill out. And also, I didn't really see too many people. Like, the only person I saw was Brittany, and I saw her as we were both leaving at around 2 o'clock. So, I don't know, I didn't enjoy it. But anyways, I figured I'd show you guys what I got from IMATS, because typically I don't really buy anything, but because this year there wasn't really anyone to talk to, I guess I did buy stuff, I don't know. But anyways, I'll show you guys what I got, and the first thing I'll show are these two brushes, and I'm not 100% sure on the brand of them either, because the store was called Designer Brand Brushes or something like that, so I don't actually know what the brand of these are. They look very similar to Sigma, which was also there, but that line was crazy. I was not lining up for that. And they're only around $8 to $11 each, so they were pretty cheap as well. But the first one is this angled brush here, which I've used both of these. I'm sorry, but I use my stuff when I buy it, so this is just an angle brush here. I really wanted one more so for contouring, just because I always use my stippling brush, which is over here. You guys always see it. It's an e.l.f. stippling brush, and it's not really a precise kind of application to get a contour like this. So I wanted to get one of these so I could explore more with contouring. And then the other brush I got, I totally didn't need, because it's just another blending brush. But in my opinion, you can never have too many, because they're the most common ones that I use personally. And again, this was from the same stall, so I don't exactly know the brand, but it's pretty much a dupe for the MAC 217. So as you can see, they've got the kind of white fluffy tips on them, so they're great for blending. The next two things are lipsticks, and they're from Makeup Store, and I don't own anything from Makeup Store, so I was pretty enthusiastic to get into their stand to just try their stuff out. And also they had 60% off and 30% off certain things, so I was all over it. So I got two of the lipsticks. The first one is in Scarlet, and this one was 60% off. I don't really know why. I don't know if they're discontinued or anything, but this one was 60% off, so I think it was definitely under $20. I can't remember how much. I think maybe $13 or something, but it was super duper cheap. So it's just a bright, very, very neon orange color, which the camera's not really showing as much, but if I do that, you can kind of see. So it's just a very, very bright neon color, but when I swatch it, you can see it's just kind of a sheared out jelly kind of finish to it. I don't know. I thought it was really pretty, just so it's not super neon and in your face. It's just a softer kind of version of it. And then the other lipstick I got is in Magic, and this one was only 30% off, I believe. So I think it was a little over $20, maybe $24, but still, when I saw the color, I was all over it. And as you can see, it's a very, very dark purple color, and it looks so good on. As soon as I bought this, I went and applied it, and I wish I wore it all day because it looks so good. But it's in the color Magic, and again, it's got a nice sheer finish to it, but as you can see, it's that really nice deep purple kind of color, which I don't own any of these deep purples that are sheer to the point where they don't look like black, so really, really like this one. Very, very happy. That one's actually my favourite one. And then I also got one more thing from Lime Chrome, which thank God they made the store bigger this year, because last year it was so small and there was just hundreds of people around it, whereas this year they made it massive, so it was a little bit easier to get to it. And the only reason why I went there was for this eyeliner here. Now this is the liquid liner in Lazuli, but as you can see, it's just this really cobalt neon blue kind of color, same as my shirt and same as my nails. So I don't know, I've been really liking this color lately, so I got this one, and I think it was around $18 or something. Around $18 or something, but I have it on my eyes today, which you'll see in another video of mine soon. But seriously, the best blue liquid eyeliner I've seen. I've been hunting this down for so long, and I thought I might as well save it for IMATS so I can actually buy something there, so finally got my hands on it. But aside from that, I figured I would talk to you guys about why I've kind of been absent from YouTube. I don't want to make this a huge downer, but I'm not 100% in my spirits. I don't know if you guys can tell in my video. Hopefully not. I'm trying to like act happy for you guys, but I don't know. My life's just kind of at a halt and a standstill at the moment. I'm not going to go into too much personal details just because I don't like sharing too much on the internet, but I mean, there's stuff happening at home. There's something happening in the background. You might have seen on my Instagram, my cat was sick a couple of weeks ago. He was on the brink of death pretty much. Like, he nearly died unless we took him to the vet. So we took him in. He's much better now. He's nearly 100%, so he's a lot better, thank God. but that vet bill is very expensive, so we kind of have a financial strain on our family now. And on top of that, my fish Sonic is now sick. I don't know if anyone considers fish as pets, but I really do. They're my favorite. And Sonic is my very first fish that I ever got. He is a blue fighter and he has dropsy at the moment, which if you are a fish enthusiast, you'll know that dropsy is one of the most severe diseases that they can get, and they normally die. So it's really stressing me out at the moment, and I spend a lot of my day just kind of watching him and looking after him. I have to give him medicine and all these kind of things, and it's a lot of work for a little fish, and he can die at any moment. So it's just stressing the hell out of me. I feel like I'm just watching over his tank 24/7. So that's kind of happening in the background. And on top of that, at uni, I'm in my 8th week, so a lot of things are due at the moment. And as well, at the end of this semester, I go on prac, but I have to go out of area. So prac essentially is where I go into a classroom and I actually be a teacher, so I can kind of learn more about the job that I'm studying for. So at this time, I have to go out of area, and it's for 4 weeks, so it's an entire month that I'm away from home. And I applied for Foster, which is 2 hours away from here in Newcastle, but I've been knocked back. I didn't get it. So I don't know what I'm going to do now. I can't go much further. I can't be too far away from home. I don't like being away from home, to be honest. And I also need to be able to support myself, because they're not paying for me to go away. Like, I'm not getting paid to be the teacher. I'm literally supporting myself. I have to pay for my accommodation, how I'm getting there, all my food that I have to eat while I'm there. And it's such a financial and an emotional strain. It just sucks. And to find that I might have to go further is really, it's like top of my list stressing me out at the moment. So I don't really know how I'm going to go with regards with YouTube with that, how I'm going to be able to make videos if I'm that far away. I don't even know if I'm going to have internet access. Like, I really don't even know what the hell's going to happen to me for those 4 weeks. So I'm hoping to get it all sorts out. I've asked for Port Macquarie, which is a little bit further, but anything further than that, and I'm just going to have to like collapse, because I can't do it. Oh, also, while I was at uni the other day, someone hit my car. I'll show you a picture of it just so you can see it's not that severe. But to me, I love my car. She's nearly 20 years old, but she's in perfect condition. So to have someone hit my car and damage it, I freaked out. I felt sick to the stomach. I actually nearly was physically sick when I found out about it. So that was just a major letdown. So it's all fixed now. It's all taken care of. But it's just a whole lot of shit happening all at once, and it's stressing me out. And I don't know. So I guess that's why I've been kind of absent from YouTube. I'm just trying to catch my feet and just kind of stand still and take on everything. So I just really don't know what's going to be happening, and it sucks because I'm someone who likes to know what's happening to me. I like to know that I can not control everything, but just kind of answer to everything and have a solution to everything, whereas right now everything's up in the air for me. Anyways, I'll wrap it up here before it gets too long, too mopey, too emotional. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this super long explanation video, but hopefully my videos will be getting back into order soon. I don't know how long it's going to take for me to get out of this rut, but I figured I'll just tell you guys what the hell's happening. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this little update video, and I will see you in my next one, which will be hopefully shortly after this one. I feel like I'm dragging this out. Okay, bye guys. Hello my kittens. Today's video is going to be a... Wait, what am I doing? Okay, that's off to a bad...